So another question that I got from an email was a gentleman who said, well, listen, I thought that nitrates and nitrites were really bad for you. So how can you advocate for me to take in more of these? So here's the controversy, right? Whenever you're eating bacon or smoked ham or salami or some of these meat products, they've used nitrates to cure them and to make them salty and to taste sweet. You know, they have that flavor that everybody looks for when they look for these smoked meats. So there were some studies years ago in animals that kind of looked at nitrates and nitrites, and they say, oh, well, we think that these are really bad. They can cause issues. But when we really start to look at the clinical data now, what we're finding is that there is a difference between a nitrite or a nitrate that you're going to get from a smoked meat versus one that you might get from a celery stalk, right? Because the celery stalk with their nitrate, the celery stalk, the beets, all of the things that we talk about regularly that can help in this process have vitamin C. Vitamin C is an antioxidant, and it helps with the process of if your body decides to change that oral nitrite or nitrate into a nitrosamine. Now, the nitrosamine is what's controversial because we feel like nitrosamines can contribute to cancer and can contribute to different diseases. So that's ultimately why we feel as though the vegetables and the fruit that have nitrates and nitrites in them and packed full of them become so therapeutic, because they have the protection of the vitamin C on board that you don't get when you're getting a smoked meat. Does that make sense? The difference between a nitrate and a nitrite from a smoked meat versus a fibrous, fruity, or vegetable that actually has vitamin C on it. So if you're in the process of, you're like, oh, well, she said nitrates, nitrites, I'm gonna go get a bunch of meat, I know that the meat has it in there. You have to keep in mind too, that we wanna minimize the amount of processed meat that we take in, because smoked meat is considered processed meat because it can increase the incidence of colon cancer. So smoked meats in moderation, processed meats in extreme moderation. That means those of you who are taking lunch meat to work, you know, you need to have more of a natural version of the meat. It should be organic if possible, farm raised, grass fed if possible, but also, even though that smoky thing makes the food taste really good, it's really not that great for you in long term. We've increased our incidence of stomach cancer, colon cancer. And so that's the difference between the nitrate-rich foods that are coming from maybe celery and spinach and beets and this and that versus the nitrates that we would get if we consume some ham, some smoked ham, right? So that's the difference. So noting that when you are taking in a nitrate from smoked ham, and if that's your diet and if that's how you've been living, you know, having the antioxidants on board, like the vitamin C and some of the other things that we talk about regularly, is going to help maybe balance that out. But honestly, we just need to cut back on it. You just cannot live off of barbecued meat and smoked meat. As good as it is, it's just, the data is very clear there that we need to limit it because it does increase the risk of different cancers.